Just another brother dead in the streets. Just another mother gonna make a funeral speech. Niggas killing one another twice as much as we breed. The system's engineered so that we don't succeed. Contaminate us with drugs and disease. Observations, bugs, new technology. Retaliations, big guns are sure to be bursting. Have to move cautiously, tomorrow's not certain. You listen, you can call me a fucked up person. This life has made me what I am, and I'm always learning. That product makes me generate my earnings. Keep a gun every day, test me, I'm going out bursting. Nicked with a machine, even the fool sound comfortable. Messing up the scene, a nigga filling up the constable. I can't front to you, I hate the police. And these prison officers that get their powers from keys. Like we supposed to bow and be on our knees. Can't oppose the untruths they want us to believe. Can't you see they wanna see us deceased? I'd rather die on my feet than live on my knees. The biggest threat to them is my seed. Mini U's and mini me's, a team of fucking marines. On some revolution shit and willing to bleed. Firing their soul conceived on Guinness and weed. Wish I could hide this world away from my babies. But at an early age children are going on shady. The beast has shown his face and now these people are crazy. Niggas bursting, niggas on the roadside daily. But I'm a winner dog, they can't contain me. And I discover with the mind God gave me what's undercover and their mental slaveries. For all my fellow brothers, pray they change, G. Inside I bear the light with melanin in my skin. But they distract my eyes with evil things such as heroin. Prostitution's worth billions in this city of sin. I'd be a rotting corpse before I let reptilians win. Make a joyful noise, but that's the reason I sing. My maker bless me with this gift that I possess from within. But the future for my people's looking cloudy and grim. And I blame the fascist leaders and the far right wing. They got the streets so that your brother will die for you. Building extra prisons so your kids can't cover you. Controlling the death toll with Brown and W. Are you listening? Got a hole and strap down ready for who's gonna trouble you. It seems there ain't a hope in hell for my peeps. But I refuse to be a pawn and let the order proceed. Expose the flaws that's in the laws for all my brothers to see. Unite my niggas squeezing triggers at the BNP. Bang, bang.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for tuning in. Context of White Supremacy. Gusty Renegade Justice in for another program, and we had a lot of folks who were very pleased about having black people on the program from different parts of the world, and I wanted to continue that. I think I had been saying that a lot in January that I wanted to reach out. There were people in the United Kingdom, non-white people, black people who were listening to the program. And I wanted to try to continue to expand that. So I believe we have more black people from the UK on the program, and we'll be attempting to get more of the folks on. The folks that are already on the line, just so you can introduce yourself to the audience, I believe we have Poel and Mike on the line. Are both of you with us?
Greetings.
Peace and blessings, family.
Groovy. I'm going to see in your area.
You want to go first, Mike, or should I get this one?
You go. Go ahead. Go ahead.
Okay. What I see is an increasing display of the mixture and the bonding relationship-wise in regards to black males and Caucasians, mutants, people, whatever you want to call them. Especially on advertisements, I'm seeing a lot more of the promotion of these interracial couples. It's now becoming to the point where it's pretty much every advertisement you see, we've either got a brother with a mutant, or we've got a sister with a mutant, and they're not advertising anything to do with potential relationships. They're advertising everything under the sun, from nappies to hair products to whatever it may be. So it's very subtle, but to the trained eye, it's very overt and blatant. So that's one of the main things I'm seeing, is the advertisements, obviously the television, the programming, the movies. They're really pushing this agenda forward, and unfortunately some of our brothers and sisters are falling to the wayside and thinking, let's embrace this new way of going, rather than sticking to the norm, what is natural and what is right, to be with someone who reflects you. So that's what I see. That's what I see at the moment.
I don't know. Is it an environment where you can kind of point this out? Like if you tell other non-white people, hey, do you see all these commercials where they're showing, you know, a non-white person or black person dating, having sex with a white person? Are you able to point that out and talk about it? Or is that something that most non-white people, they're totally confused on?
They're confused. It's a case of they understand it and they'll see it, but the same thing, the usual sort of line comes out where it's, oh, well, you know, that's what we do now. You know, that's acceptable. We're allowed to date outside of our race. We're allowed to procreate and create babies which have quote-unquote dual heritage. You know, that's the thing now. Rather than, you know, as I say, looking at self like most people do, unfortunately, our sisters and brothers are sort of, as I say, they're falling by the wayside. They're not really looking at the bigger picture, because in the 4 or 5 years generation's time, if everyone's taking this very light view of things, then where will us as a people be? I don't think there will be a race, if you want to call us a race. I don't believe we're a race, but there won't be a race of so-called black people walking the face of this earth. There'll be a mixture of all types of people, of beings. So that people, are, unfortunately, you've got one or two people in an isolated pocket who you can actually build with and obviously have some dialects and good discussions with. But the majority of the people, they just want to say that's the way it is now. You know, we can accept it. This is part of the society. We're integrated. You know, let's just embrace it all.
Wow. Very familiar. I saw that term too, dual heritage. That's one of the new terms they tossed out in that area of the world. I think I saw that about 2 or 3 years ago. Is that a newer term over there, dual heritage?
They've been promoting, obviously, because it's all about trying to get away from what, you know, 10 years ago, we never heard of that term. You know, if someone was mixed race, there was mixed race. Now, then they change the terms to make it a little bit more politically correct. It's all the same thing. You got the sacrament, the same thing, but just totally repackaged to make it, as I say, sound a bit more and feel a bit more user friendly.
Mm.
And people sort of wear it. Unfortunately, it's getting to a point where people are sort of wearing it as a badge of honor rather than saying, you know, yeah, I'm black and I'm proud, or I'm a pink person, I'm proud. You know, I'm dual heritage. You know, the first thing I want to do is I want to get myself a pink person, and I want to procreate and create this idyllic dual heritage little baby, little chocolatey-headed baby. It is madness to me, absolute madness.
Wow. Wow. I hope people, same package worldwide, pushing that sexual confusion, get non-white people to want to hop in bed with white people. I don't know. Are you all seeing the same thing with regards to the so-called homosexual behavior? Because they're pushing a lot of that over here, along with having sex with white people. Are you all seeing that too?
Yes, definitely. I'm seeing a lot of this homo anti-sexual behavior being pushed. And also, to touch on what the brother just said, with these, what are they, so-called interracial relationships arising now. I mean, black males have been in these sexual relationships with white females for a very long time, but now what I'm seeing now, they're pushing the black females with the white males. There's an increase in that. I believe you call them tragic arrangements. There's an increase in these so-called relationships, and also the homosexual agenda they're pushing. There's a lot of confusion going on at the moment, skinny jeans and the Mohicans, and the young people, they're speaking a total different language and we can't really understand them. They don't really speak English, and yeah, there's a lot of sexual confusion going on at the moment.
Wow.
Most deaths. And just to build on and add on to that, it's, you've got to think of, obviously, the United States of America is a superpower, and we look, you know, especially here in the UK, we look over to you guys for, you know, what's going on, you know, for that. For people like us, we're looking at, so, you know, building some knowledge, getting that foundation, understanding ourselves a bit more. But for other people, they're looking for entertainment. They're looking for the next trend. So we're looking over there, and all we're seeing is men in outlandishly bright clothes, tight legging type jeans, and we're thinking, yo, that's the way to be. Men are flossing, stuff like that over there, and, you know, and women are loving it. So that's the type of image that I need to, you know, to project over here. So it's a kind of a sort of a baby seeing what the father's doing and copying them blatantly rather than thinking independently for themselves. Actually, you know what? 5 years ago, I was wearing baggy clothes. And now, all of a sudden, I'm wearing tight clothes and really bright, girly kind of colours and pinks and all of that kind of stuff. And I'm sitting back trying to just basically hold my own, really, and trying to, you know, dip in where I can and drop the jewels where I can with the little ute them and say, look, yo, this is not what it is. Pick up a book and start to read and start to understand what, you know, what's actually going on. Why are they pushing this agenda onto you? You're wearing these tight clothes now. What's going to happen in 2 years' time? What are you going to be doing? You're going to be a batty man.
In the 70s and early 80s, people were more conscious then because they had the Rasta movement, because a lot of people were interested in them times. Yeah. And then when the 80s came, a lot of people trimmed their hair and started wearing the curly perm and dating white women and etc.
See, the key thing was there, though, brother. It was the latter. They put that pink dark woman in front of the Rasta man who knew he shouldn't have been messing with that beer. And then he started to eat the pork. And then he started to deal with it. You know what I'm saying? And then from there, the culture just went, because you can't be in old dread and deal with pork and deal with pink women.
Yeah, because, I mean, this part of the neck of the woods was so conscious then. I mean, now, what I see with the youth is that they're all in gangs.
Because they fear the reprisal. They know if they come to
they do.
Which is meaning rich, they know at the end of the day, more time, we ain't going to have no kind of conversation with no police or no policy enforcement officer. We ain't going to talk to them on our own. We're going to try and deal with it on our own, or we're just going to keep quiet and see what we're doing. Whereas the pig man, he's going to be the first, he's going to be on the phone from when he sees that, when he even smells the essence of melanin in his presence, he's going to be on the phone to the holy saying, yeah, you need to come down here and get. That, to me personally, obviously, everything that comes out of my mouth is my opinion. People may not agree with it, but Dizzy Rascal, for me, he ain't no artist.
Well, the system will promote people like that and say, right, oh, there you are, this is another black artist doing successful in inverted commas.
Mm-hmm.
And then you guys can make it if you try hard enough. You could become a next Dizzy Rascal or whatever.
Yeah. But that's what it's about.
There's a few in.
The only thing they want us to do is to entertain. We can either sing, dance, tell jokes, or play athletic sports.
Yeah, typically.
In regards to using our minds, which is the most powerful thing we have, they now want for us to use that.
Yeah, I would agree with that.
He's just basically a victim of white supremacy. That's what I need to really say.
But yeah, that's true. Sometimes you can't even blame them. They're just being used as a pawn in the system.
But at the same time, everyone needs to take accountability. There needs to be a point in everyone's life when they say, well, what am I doing? What I'm doing now, is that conducive to creating something successful, not just for me, but for future generations, for my community, for my family and my friends?
Yeah, that's true.
You know, it's about accountability, ultimately. That's why I always say it comes down to having a thorough knowledge of self, because you can't go wrong then. You can't build a house without the foundation, and I put that knowledge of self as the foundation in that analogy. You need to have that before you can build anything, and at the moment people are just walking around with no foundation.